The Selesnya Conclave often have ambassadors. They believe in the world soul, and if you can have a balance with nature, then you can have that same balance with the peoples of Ravnica. I spoke with Ari Levitch about this unique guild.
The Selesnya Conclave is the guild that believes that the individual is not as important as the group. The Selesnya believe that society and nature should and can live in harmony with each other. And by extension, everyone who lives in that city can do that too, can live in harmony with each other. They follow the will of the world soul, which is called Mat Selesnya, which is where they get their name. And the Selesnya is for, they believe that peace is what should be strived for, essentially above everything, peace and harmony. But they also are aware that because of these nine other guilds, peace is not necessarily a foregone conclusion. So they are sometimes seen as like the sleeping dragon, where this notion of if you people think that they're not really a formidable force, but if you were really to kind of get them going, they will really kind of unleash their vast numbers. They're a very numerous guild that are always actively evangelizing and trying to get new people to join the conclave. But again, all of this comes from a very, very spiritual place, that they believe that the will of the world soul is for everybody to kind of embrace this harmonious life.
Who usually gravitates towards this?
The races that gravitate toward the Selesnya, there are a bunch of elves, there are humans, there are centaurs. There's the other race that we're seeing here are the humanoid kind of elephant people called Luxodons. And the Luxodons are kind of can be very mild-mannered and slow to anger, but obviously they're very powerful individuals. So if you do kind of get them in that state, they're very powerful fighters, but they can be kind of very serene as monks or clerics, and oftentimes they take on the role as ambassadors to other guilds or to the city, or evangels trying to get more people to the conclave. So for a lot of people, they're seen as a force that is charitable, that will do acts of kindness, and they are a source of order in potentially a chaotic place. But there's also kind of a sense of fear with the Selesnya, that people are kind of nervous about how powerful they could become because of their kind of evangelizing spirit. In its more darker take, people might see them as almost cult-like, that you're going to lose yourself as an individual to the will of this larger group. So their organization is pretty flat, but they have these different kind of communities that are each kind of overseen by a dryad, because dryads in their makeup are closer to nature than any other beings, really. So they speak for or with the kind of voice of Mat Selesnya, the world soul, and even though like through their voice, other people will then also take up that kind of chorus.
Thank you, Ari Levitch, for once again talking to us about the Guildmaster's Guide to Ravnica. That book is available right now on dndbeyond.com. I am your host, Todd Kenrick. Thank you so much for watching.